this whole situation come about with you being out here?
You know, just have had conversations with John. I want to be around a little bit more, and I just feel energized just being around the players, being in the meetings with Coach Gruden and Greg Olsen and Brian Callahan, and getting the quarterback tip sheets. It just brought me back to those years where I was here as a quarterback with John and the players and the coaches and out of practice. It's been a great week, and I'm excited. I'm excited for this football team, and I'm really excited for Derek Carr. I came away, you know, you feel like you know the player a little bit. You know his game, but I got a chance to really watch him interact with John. He's all football. He loves it. He loves competing. But his aptitude, to me, was really impressive. His ability to process a ton of volume and information and responsibility in the huddle at the line of scrimmage, they're going to put a lot on his shoulders, and he can certainly handle it.
You know, talking about Derek, obviously he's going to, you know, this team is going to go as Derek goes, and it's only been a couple of days that you've had a chance to watch him, but you mentioned just kind of his aptitude and his understanding of the offense. What has really stood out to you when you take a look at what he's done the past 72 hours?
I think his overall command, I mean, keep in mind, they've only been together a couple months. I think his overall command of the offense, of the system, of the tools that he has in his toolbox to get in and out of plays, to change protections. Keep in mind, if you really go back and study Derek Carr, there's been a lot of change around him. You know what I mean? Had Greg Olsen as his coordinator his first year. He's had, I think, three or four different coordinators in four seasons. That's hard. And he's been able to come out, he's been able to survive it, and he's got a guy now that's going to call plays, that's going to have him as prepared as any player in the league. And that's the thing I tried to impress upon Derek. He's going to be so much further along on game days. He's going to have a better anticipation of what's coming. I think the communication between him and John is phenomenal. And that's the one thing that's impressed me. The other thing that's impressed me is his athleticism. I mean, he's a lot more. He's got better feet than I anticipated. He can run with the football. He can escape and make plays, extend plays. So I think you'll see more of him moving around a little bit, some by design and some by out of necessity.
You know, you mentioned kind of that change that Derek's gone through, it seems like, each year here. And I think John's his fourth head coach now, heading into year five. Now, finally, with some consistency in the playbook and the guy calling the plays and all that stuff, you know, how beneficial is that going to be for a quarterback who, while he's going into year five, is still very much rising in this game?
Yeah, he's a developing player, and he's already been to Pro Bowls and those type of things. So I just think that the stability around that position is absolutely vital. And I think with John being here, John's not going anywhere. I think that's great for Derek. I think John is maybe the best play caller in the game. People say, well, he's been away from the game 10 years. I would tell you that he really hasn't been away from the game in 10 years. He's been down in that little laboratory of his down in Tampa, grinding away, studying, visiting with coaches, studying schemes, studying college players. So I think he's got a really good sense of what he wants to do. I think he's put together an outstanding staff. You look at the assistant coaches, and I think the guy that's really going to benefit is Derek. But I just think the stability around him, the continuity, the consistency, everyone's being on the same page. The communication's going to improve, and I think that'll really help a guy like Derek Carr.
You know, in talking to a bunch of people since Coach has come back, you know, the one thing that's been a consistent theme is that it's going to be a learning curve for Derek. He's going to get a lot of stuff thrown at him, especially this first season. As a guy who's been in the shoes that Derek's in right now, what should he really expect from his first full season with Coach Gruden?
You know, I don't really worry about Derek. It's not always what Derek can handle. It's what the other 10 players in the huddle can handle. The issue is not going to be too much volume for Derek Carr. The issue, more often than not, will be, is it too much for the offensive line and the receivers and the skill players? It's not going to be too much for Derek Carr. He's a smart guy. He loves football. He's had a ton of experience. I think the situations that he's gone through early in his career with all the changes with the systems and terminology and play callers and stuff like that, and yet he's been able to survive it and come out of it and is still in one piece, I think says a lot about his toughness, his ability to overcome adversity. So I just think that it is year one in the system. I think they'll continue to add. This system will continue to evolve as John learns more about Derek and what he's good at and what he likes. But I think they're well on their way to becoming very familiar and very comfortable with one another.
I mean, you're no stranger to coming to Raiders practices, obviously coming out as an analyst. But, you know, it feels like there's a different kind of vibe, a different energy with Coach Gruden and his staff here. Is that something that you picked up on at all?
No question. I said to the players this morning, I don't know that there's a coach in football that I've been around that has more energy and passion than Jon Gruden. The other thing I would tell you is that he was blessed with some really good DNA, some really good genes from his mom and dad. And one of the genes that he has that I think is unique, and I think it's the reason he and I hit it off so well, is for whatever reason, Jon feels like he has to prove himself every day of his life. I think when he comes in here, he's the head football coach, doesn't matter to him. He feels like he's got to prove something. He feels like he's got to prove to the defensive staff that he's got a great system of football. And I think it's what drives him. I think it's what motivates him. I think it's why he and I had such symmetry and a great rapport with one another, because I think I'm wired the same way. I really feel like I just, every day I came in here as a player, I had to grind and really work at my craft to become a good player, to earn the respect of my teammates and coaches, and I felt like I had to do that every day. Jon feels that way. I think Derek Carr has some of that same DNA. I just really believe that he feels like it's all out there for him. He wants it all. He wants to be a world champion. He wants to be the best in the business. And I just think that if you can match John's enthusiasm, his attitude, his tempo, his hunger, his passion, then I think good things will happen.
You know, you mentioned that you spoke to the team this morning, kind of kicking off this final day of the off-season workout program. What was really your message to them, and you know, what did you want to get across to them before they go away now for the next, you know, 6 or so weeks?
I think there's a couple different themes. I think the big one was I really want them to start taking care of one another, start really caring for one another. And I think accountability to me is a big thing. You know, if you come into this building, I always said that the last thing I wanted to do was disappoint Jon Gruden as a player. I knew how hard he worked during the week to put me in a position to be successful on Sunday. The last thing I wanted to do was go out and play poorly. The last thing I wanted to do was have a bad year, a bad couple seasons, and get my position coach fired. And so if you care for those people and they care for you, you care for one another, I think great things can happen. And I tried to impress upon the players, this is a tremendous staff. This whole building is filled with great people. And when you start caring about each other that way, I think great things will happen. And I tried to tell the players that they've got to take ownership in this operation. You know, you have to, a good football coach hands the leadership of the football team back over to the veteran players. What are they going to do with that? And with that comes enormous responsibility. And I just tried to impress, I said, who are the leaders going to be in the position groups? Who are the leaders going to be on the defensive side of the ball? Who are the leaders going to be, you know, on the offensive side of the ball, and who's willing to mentor the young players? And if we can start to do those things, then I think some great things will happen. And I also try to tell them that when Jon came here, it didn't take long for us to get things turned around. My first 4 years, we won 3 AFC West titles, went to 2 AFC championship games, went to a Super Bowl. It doesn't take long if you got the right people and everyone's committed to doing the same type of work. And I think it won't be very long before Jon gets this thing headed in the right direction.
I mean, you talked about just the leaders and, you know, obviously Derek, one of the, if not the leader of this team. But, you know, as we've seen year in and year out, that depth is so crucial on, you know, in the NFL, particularly at the quarterback position. And I know you've had a chance to look at all the quarterbacks right now. There's 3 of them on the roster. And Coach said behind Derek, you know, it's an open competition essentially between EJ and Connor. I mean, just what have you seen from the 2 of them? Granted, they don't get a ton of run during practice, but just – what do those 2 guys bring to the table?
Both talented players, both have, you know, the size that you love at the position, both can throw, push the ball down the field. I think the challenge that both of them have is just getting reps and getting experience in the system. And unfortunately, with the collective bargaining agreement the way it is, you don't get to spend as much time with those players that you normally would. You don't have the, you know, 6-week quarterback school, and you know, you're not spending, you know, 180 hours in the classroom setting. You know, you're not afforded that opportunity, and so it's a lot of catching up that has to happen on their with both of them, and they're not getting the reps out on the practice field, because in the mini camps you only have a limited amount of reps. So who are you going to give them to? Well, this is Derek's first year in the system, let's get Derek as many reps as he can get. And so then you struggle finding out more about Connor and EJ, but they're good players that need experience in the system, need to be coached hard. And one of those 2 players has to really step up at training camp and take advantage of the opportunity and really establish themselves as a guy that the team can count on in the unlikely situation something would happen to Derek.
You know, I think this team has been built in such a way where Derek is going to be protected and he's going to have a lot of options on the outside and what to do with the ball in terms of offensive weapons. And, you know, key to that is Amari Cooper, right? And you look at Coop, all the talent in the world, but, you know, kind of a struggle for him last year, right? After these 2,000-yard, you know, blockbuster season, kind of comes back to earth a little bit. As a quarterback, do you feel like you have to say something to him to get him back on track, or do you kind of just let him work through whatever he needs to work through to get back to where he knows he could be?
I think you have to get to know him and what, you know, how he's wired and what, you know, how he responds to coaching and play calls. And I think John's in the process of finding out. They put a couple routes in for him the other day, some individual cuts that he just was terrific with. So you know that there's going to be some design. Like, I think what's unique about John's system of football is there were certain plays in for Tim Brown, certain cuts. There were certain plays in for Jerry Rice. There's going to be certain plays in the offense for Amari Cooper, for Jordy Nelson, for Martavis Bryant. And so I just think that's a unique group. I think getting Jordy Nelson in this building is going to be great for that young wide receiver room. He's a veteran. He's a professional. He does things the right way. And that's going to rub off on everybody. But I just think Amari Cooper is such a talented player. You just watch him out there run routes. His size, his speed, his ability to separate, his power, his ability to go high point of football. So I think it's just, you know, getting him off to a good start. I think that's always important, getting his confidence going early, and then just watching him flourish in a system that I think is cut out for him.
You know, Coach, since he came back, has really put an emphasis on getting former players, you know, guys who have such a rich history with this program, back in the building to kind of impart their wisdom on, you know, this next generation of Raiders. And now to kind of see it here in the flesh, you're back, you're, you know, taking in this 3-day minicamp, is it kind of nice to see, especially at a place like this where there's such an emphasis on the history?
It is, and I think that, you know, John had, although he wasn't here long enough, he made a huge impact in this building. And I think people saw the level of professionalism, the attention to detail, his work ethic, his passion for the game. I think it rubbed off on a lot of people. I know if it weren't for Jon Gruden, I wouldn't be sitting here today. You know, and so I think players appreciate that. I think sometimes players have a chance to look back that and say, I wish I could have done more at the time. But I think it's great that John's recognizes that people can come in and be mentors to young players and help them out a little bit. And it's good to see guys like Ricky Dudley in the building and, you know, Napoleon Kaufman and Zach Crockett out of the practice field. And guys that, you know, I know other guys that have come through here and Charles Woodson and, you know, guys that the players really look up to and respect and admire.
You know, it seems like each year, time and time again, the rumors of Gruden's return to the sidelines would come. Were you surprised when it actually, this was the year, this was the situation that got him out of the booth back on the sidelines?
I had had some conversations with him and Mark Ortega and some different people, and just, you know, I got the sense that, I mean, even from really the first year that John was out of football, I was convinced that he was going to get back in at some point. I just think he thinks of himself as a football coach. It's what he does. He loves football. He wants to be around it, and he wants to be calling plays and coaching players. And he just wasn't going to get that same fix in a broadcast booth. And so I was surprised, quite frankly, that he did television as long as he did. He was very good at it. But when this opportunity presented itself, and there had been a lot of other opportunities, and I think even – you know, the Tampa Bay situation was an interesting, you know, because John was living in Tampa, and I think there was interest on the part of the Buccaneers. But I just think in his mind, he felt like there was some unfinished business here in Oakland. I think he's got great respect for Mark Davis. I know he loves the area. I know he loves Raider fans. And I just felt like he felt like there was some unfinished business here. He got traded away. He was building what was going to be a really special team for a long time. And he's got a young quarterback that's got him really excited about football again, and he thinks he can get it done again and win here big time, and I think he can as well.
You know, that unfinished business theme has kind of been something that he's come back to, but he said a couple of times, he goes, you know, I kind of grew up here as a coach, as a man, and it seems like everything's kind of coming full circle now for him to come back and, like you said, finish what he started.
He was one of the youngest coaches in football when Mr. Davis hired him, and he did. He cut his teeth here with the Raiders, and you know, he had an unbelievable opportunity, and he took advantage of it. He did some great things. I mean, he did some great things. When I first got here in '99, it was John's second year, and we were still developing a system of football. We were still trying to build structure and consistency with our football team, and in the process of turning over the roster and getting in the right type of players that, you know, that were going to be good players for us for a long time. And so that was taking a while, but we were getting the results. I mean, in our second year, I think we went 12-4 and went to the AFC Championship game. And so I think he's a much different coach. I think he's much more mature. I think he's got much more experience. I think that he's got a better vision of what he wants to try and accomplish. And I don't think it's going to take very long. I really don't. I mean, I think they've got a good roster. I think they'll continue to develop the roster in some key areas. But, man, this business is tough when you don't have a trigger, and they've got a trigger. The guy, a quarterback, is a pretty special player, and I think John realizes that, and I think some great things are going
to
happen.
If there's anything we've ever done that I'm particularly proud of, I would have to say that the perpetuation of the greatness of the Raiders to take a professional football team and give it a distinct characteristic that's different from all others.
I'm going to tell you something, man. If you guys don't know how big a win that was, you'll know tomorrow. It's a hell of a win. It's a team effort. Offense, defense, special teams. Now, the effort was outstanding.
Yes, sir. Outstanding. Yes, sir.